5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
What's going on, nation? Welcome, everybody.
Hello, isolation units around the world. We have no more sports. We have no more sports. And we have no more sports. So the only thing you can watch is us. So we're here to make you happy, because today is International Happy Day.
It is?
Apparently, yeah, I think so. I don't know.
I'm crying.
Today we're filming as 316 day. The dog is licking my feet. The fucking walrus. Get off of me, walrus. Get off of me. We have to talk about shit. God damn it. Holy fuck, the dog wars. Holy, here we go.
I get attacked by the lion.
Yeah.
Stop it.
It's okay.
Put her in a headlock. Stop. Pinch her nipples, something.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Take it.
But we're here. It's,
What is number today?
I don't remember.
138, I think.
Yeah, we're on episode 138.
On 140, I gotta be dead.
So far.
We're healthy.
Yeah, we're healthy, I think. I don't know if we're infected.
I try go nowhere.
Yeah.
And you going just to work.
I go everywhere.
And they close gyms.
Yeah, they shut down the gym. I can't exercise. I'm going to get fat now.
We can exercise at home. Push-ups.
Yeah, yeah, right. With this fucker.
Push-up competition.
With this fucker.
We close this guy in a room so he no bother. And then we do... We have dumbbells, 30 pounds each. You can do lots.
Yeah, I'm going to work out at home. Fucking kill me. Fucking.
No, well, that's what you're supposed to do. Even O'Hara, Mike O'Hara said, we're working out at home. They closed his glove gym.
That's bullshit.
Yeah. So everybody, even Jean-Claude Van Damme coming back from Australia.
We need to spend all of our money on gym equipment.
No.
And we need to build a gym in the living room.
Right away. What happened? You're gonna push my car around the fucking block.
Block? Yeah. Holy fuck,
that's leg day.
Yeah.
And then you're gonna make squats with me on the back.
Okay.
That's leg day.
Leg day, okay. What else are we gonna do for exercise?
Push-up competition to the numbness.
Till numbness. Or numb chest?
Yeah, we're gonna go one, two. One, two, who first died.
Okay.
And probably I'm gonna win. I can bet money now.
Okay.
Because I'm not so heavy.
Sure.
Even my arm is fucked one.
You haven't been to the gym in like 5 years, so fuck.
No, I was. Two weeks ago.
2 weeks ago?
Yeah, when
doing what?
I have a picture.
Yeah, but what were you doing at the gym?
Yeah, like everything a little bit.
The fuck does that mean? Like, I went there, took a shit in the toilet.
No.
Then I took a drink from the water fountain.
No.
Then I fucking scratched my head.
That's true.
And then I went in the tanning bed.
That's true.
And then I went home.
No. I went exercise. I think so it was 45 minutes.
Okay.
It was hands.
Yeah.
Like a biceps, triceps machine.
Yeah.
Because I can't do biceps too much. So I have to separate this arm doing like 80 pounds the maximum dumbbells.
Yeah.
And this one only 20.
Oh, bless you, coronavirus.
And then I did arms, triceps, no problem doing.
Yeah.
Then I do this chest machine.
Yeah.
You know, in the front of the mirror where I like it to do.
Okay.
Then I go on, do the squats.
Okay.
With 45s.
Yeah.
4 times 7.
Is 11-11.
Yeah, and then I lift myself a little bit on this. I can go with this arm more than 5.
Yeah.
But I, on the in, I can do like little different, just in for sure. And this one.
Why can't go out? Oh, fuck. Social distance. Social distance.
They say don't sneeze.
Holy fuck.
Okay, so I...
You're dying already? Jesus.
I know, I should have a mask.
Holy fuck. We need a wall.
You know
why? You know how Donald Trump said build the wall? We need it for coronavirus people, wall. This is getting crazy.
You saying this finally?
Yeah.
I told you that. I know it is going to happen. Like I said to my daughter yesterday, she's still in Hawaii, tried coming back home. And then I said to her, you know, like I go to the store here and I see empty shop, I feel like I went to Poland 1985. was nothing over there too.
Yeah.
You know, and the truck coming. And
well, you guys had nothing anyways in general from the beginning.
No, no, we haven't.
Yeah, yeah, Poland, we had nothing. Well, you still have nothing. Don't be bragging so much.
No, but like I'm saying, oh, like for me, that's like, oh. Yeah, and just, I know how buy stuff because yeah. how you survive. So what do you need? If you see something, like yesterday, I bought it one paper towel. Even I have lots of paper towels, but I say, oh, I'm gonna buy just one. Let the people have more if they come and see. And then I say, oh, napkins. Napkins gone in the Walmart. Napkins not gone in different stores. So I say, okay, one napkins. I don't have napkins. So okay. Just one. Not be crazy and fucking do. I could load fucking whatever is there.
Yeah.
But I say, no, one. Every time I'm going, at least I come back with one product. That's mm-hmm. my law.
Interesting.
Yeah, so if I go, like today I bought chicken, I couldn't buy chicken, it was too early.
Yeah.
On both, Superstore and Walmart, no chicken.
Okay.
I'm not going to Costco anymore, because it's fucking craziness over there.
Why don't you just go outside and catch a chicken?
Yes, no chickens outside either. But anyway, so the same thing, I see they're making, so I have to go a little bit later by chicken for a baby. And that's only for her, chickens.
Yeah, that's why he's fucked up. Dog food's like $3 for like a 20 kilo bag. I'm gonna buy her a chicken.
No, that's cat food.
No, that's dog
no,
food.
No, it's not dog 100, food.
100% no. You can buy some nice, cheap dog food. Big bag, like $5, probably
no.
20 kilos.
No.
This fucking little
$17.
That's so walrus.
How be I cut. Bought it first big bag cost me $105 for her.
Yeah, because you bought like fucking like Alaskan mule cow. Grass-fed,
the best thing,
crunchy bone
yeah.
from the asshole.
Then Tia bought it. Then I find out Walmart. You can buy the same bag, 100 kilo, for freaking $20.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what I'm
go
saying.
To the room. Go to the room. Yeah.
You're fucking buying.
Go
her,
sleep. Go sleep. Good. Good. Good.
You're buying her fucking like. Oh. She's fucking eating better than half of the people with the coronavirus
know,
right
I
now.
I know. That's sometimes I'm beautiful meat. I'm measure for her, and it's like. Chicken breast with freaking juice.
Wow, you get chicken breast with juice.
No, like a juice, you know, with the
yeah.
cooking chicken.
Juicy chicken breast.
And now she's like, oh, I don't want to eat this. Yeah? What's up? Go sleep. We finish the program, then we play.
Rain looks very tired.
No, she's really depressed. I think so. She maybe she eats something we drop. Like a pill or something. And she's like, you know, like,
oh,
she's like.
That's when you know you're a drug addict, when you're dropping pills on the floor everywhere.
Oh, like, you know, oh.
Oh my god, I have a. Look at my pill calendar today. We got bleach in a pill, vitamin C, vitamin D, gravel, aspirin,
yes, my
crack.
God. Yes.
The dog was they ate the crack pill.
So listen, so the situation is, like you say, it's crazy, yeah?
Yeah.
I tell you, we should follow the rules, because Italy didn't follow the rules, and then it was too late. Now everybody's sick and fucking go to hospital, and hospitals overwhelmed. They have, you know how you sick? They hook up you to ventilator. The ventilator who make breathing for you, because
okay.
your lungs,
yeah.
they run on ventilators. So yeah. they have to choose. They unhook up guy 75 years old and the other give to the guy who is 20 years old. Because they said they choosing people who have a better life approaching.
Yeah.
So they unplugging me, they yeah. plugging you.
Well, how's my foot smell like?
Like coronavirus.
Fucking Jesus. Does it smell like chicken? There's no chicken on my feet.
Yeah.
There's
so it's ridiculous.
Well,
so
I don't think people realize it's a respiratory virus.
No, it is respiratory, and you can't be close to somebody. You have to be meter at least social distance.
Yeah, social distance. That's the new
yeah.
new government phrase of the day. They're selling T-shirts tomorrow.
But you know what? What is funny was they were showing Italian like a little store, and people was in the line.
Okay.
And they actually was fucking almost, you know, like 6 meters on each Italian. They look so funny. One space, unbelievable space, another one, and they know one to another. Six, and they was waiting in line. Line was unbelievable long for bread, and to the store they let you go like 5 people at a time, that's it.
Yeah, it's fucked up. Like, yesterday everything was open, and today, like, half of the shit is closed. You're just gonna...
No, it's open still.
The government...
They go on the chops of the hours.
Listen, here. World War III is gonna start soon. No. Real soon over this
you,
shit.
You don't understand what's going on. We lucky that's not war zone thing. Nobody put poison. That's just virus. Come on.
No, the problem is that the American government is now turning like a dictatorship. And
because people didn't listen. That was the point.
No, the point is land of the free. If you choose to go outside and you get sick, that's your fault.
No, but
that's not the government's fault.
But that's why we
pay for healthcare.
No, no, because
so then
you're gonna
the healthcare
spray
more.
No, you spray on somebody.
It's not spraying; it's floating.
Yeah,
it's
but
just
then,
in the air.
But then you get sick and you give sick to other people. That's they no want you sick home.
But people don't realize it originally came from cats and dogs.
No, it was from this.
That's what they don't realize.
No.
From
this
homeless cats and dogs.
No. Was from this animal who lived there.
What's the animal?
You know the panzer thing.
What animal?
How he look like?
What
the
animal?
The and piece that look like a eat and enter, but have fucking armor. What do you call this?
There's no armadillos in China.
That's what they start.
They don't know.
Look,
they
no, they said they're armadillo.
No, not
yes,
in China.
Shut up.
Yeah, show me a Chinese armadillo.
No, I'm gonna say the armadillo, wait.
Holy, who are you Skyping?
What the hell is going on?
Holy fuck, you set up perfect today.
What? Oh, here, okay.
Yeah, it's not from...
Hey, Google. Hey Google, the armadillo start coronavirus?
Hi, I've just been reading about trailblazing women in science, arts, and politics. Say, Happy International Women's Day to hear about one.
Happy International Women's Day!
No, it was March 8th. What the fuck is she talking about? Hey Google. The armadillo in China start coronavirus?
These came back from a search.
Where's your Chinese armadillo?
Wait a second.
There's no Chinese armadillo. They're not from China.
No, he said it was armadillo.
No, it's not armadillo.
He said it was they would think it was bats, but it was actually armadillo.
No.
Yes, quiet.
Incorrect. You're wrong.
Okay, wait a second. See? Oh. There. Okay. See, here you go. That's armadillo.
Pass me the article.
See, here.
That's not an armadillo.
Well, what is that?
Pass me it. I'll tell you.
That's what they said.
Pass me the article.
That came from this
first
guy.
First of all, this looks fucked up. This is...
No, it's armadillo. That's what I said. The picture pop out.
This is called...
Go roll it up.
What is this called? Oh, I turned it off. And I have a picture of croissants. Okay, here we go. So this is called a, what the fuck is this called? A pangolin. A pangolin?
Armadillo.
It's not an armadillo.
Read.
It's a fucking pangolin. It says coronavirus, the race to find the source in wildlife. Okay, the race, deadly coronavirus jumped from animals to humans. That's what we figured out. So if people still think it was made in a lab, like a bio... Like a bioweapon?
Fake news.
Let's see here. Okay, so it says here, somewhere in China, a bat flits across the sky, leaving a trace of coronavirus in its droppings, which fall to the forest floor. A wild animal, possibly a pangolin,
which is this thing,
snuffling for insects among the leaves, picks up the infection from its excrement. Okay? So basically what happens is the bats
shit
corona.
And he eat the shit.
And then he sniffs and licks the shit.
And that's it.
And then after the fucking pangolin is filled with corona.
But that's pangolins very allergic to this, and people eat them. That's what the problem is. That's how they came to people.
The mammals gather in large colonies, fly long distance, and are present on very something. Okay.
Yeah. Oh, too much information for SoundCloud. So
what do you mean?
Granchy right now reading the tablet. And he
okay,
found finding. Hey Google. Hey Google. Hey
she
Google.
She hears you.
I want to talk if she hears me. Hey Google.
Well, now you said it three times.
Hi Tia, how can I help?
What is a pangolin? Dude.
According to Wikipedia, pangolins, or scaly anteaters, are mammals of the order Phalaenodonta.
So they're just scaly anteaters.
Oh, so they look like...
They are an anteater.
Yes.
Like how you were saying, it's an anteater?
No.
It's an anteater!
No, but it's armored anteater.
Yeah, it's an armored anteater.
And they said that fucking coronavirus sitting on his this little armor thing, and people fucking touching, and their people get it.
Yeah, so basically...
Show the picture.
I'm going to show a picture. So this is the little terrorist that's been giving us coronavirus. It looks like this, okay? It is like an armored anteater. They try to eat bugs, but the bugs are covered in bat shit, which then they just end up getting coronavirus. And now, the question is, how the fuck did this little fucker give it to humans?
They eat them!
Do they eat them?
Yeah, fry them a towel.
I'm gonna ask what delicious meals you can make from pangolin. Who eats pangolins?
These are the top results.
Okay, why are people eating pangolins? It's an article from 2015.
Ooh, they eat a long time though.
Yeah, ancient Chinese food. Women, and then there's a video. Woman shows off pangolin meals, trigger public outcry. Okay. So, basically, well, then they were kind of right at the beginning that these crazy Chinese people were eating fucked up animals.
That's what started it.
That started it. Yeah. They're not wrong about that.
Yeah.
But the animal's not bats, it's pangolins. Which is
yeah, but that's what I say. That's Amadeus, but I was thinking that name was Amadeo.
So the pangolin is the world's most illegally trafficked animal.
See? And you say, nobody eating.
And then there's an article on Vice saying the guy accidentally ate one.
Oh. Accidentally?
Yeah.
I ordered chicken wings and gave me a pangolin.
So the guy wrote, I accidentally ate the world's most illegal trafficked animal.
How was it?
Which is a pangolin.
What it tastes like a chicken?
Let's see. Maybe he describes what it tastes like. Went to a market by the side of the highway one morning with a new local friend. He picked out an unfamiliar little beast from among the carcasses, saying, you're going to love this.
That's great. You usually tell me stuff. You're going to love it.
I am a journalist on assignments in something Guinea in Central West Africa.
In Africa?
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's see. So he basically picked up a dead one from a bucket.
Yeah.
Oh, there's even a picture of him fucking skinning it. Fantastic, Vice. Wow, that's fucked up. You want to see the picture of the African man? Skinning the fucking...
Oh, we'll show it to the people.
No, I'm not... That's how you get fucking flags on YouTube.
Oh, okay.
You're showing pictures of fucking Africans skinning anteaters.
Listen, they eat everything. If you're hungry, you're eating, yeah?
So, basically, the price for a pangolin...
Pangolin.
Is $66 US. That's an expensive fucking meal.
You can buy fuck a lot of chickens for this.
You know what kind of steak you could buy for that? Jesus.
Must be really delicious.
Yeah. So that's what they look like when they're cooked.
No, they're not cooked.
That's cooked.
But why do you have armor still?
No, they skinned them.
But does look like it's still there.
No, so that's so we're looking at cooked pangolins.
Oh my which god! I'm gonna puke soon.
Which is the main source of.
They just basically put all pangolin fucking on the barbecue.
See, and then look at the beautiful goulash they come with it after.
That look like your kitchen.
Yeah, me. So they make like a nice stew with it after. Pangolin meat is dark with a sticky, stringy texture. We ate it with rice. The scales were just. Barely edible, with a crunch like a human fingernail. My friend asked if we mind if we took the head. I did not mind. He popped it in his mouth and sucked happily on the skull.
Holy fuck. I'm gonna puke today, Brendan.
This is a guy who accidentally ate the animal that carries coronavirus.
And his friend sucking on the skull of a macadam. Picky bingo wingy.
So basically says, estimate that about 10,000 intact pangolins are suffocated per year by authorities mostly in China. Their scales are currently worth about $600 US per kilo. And other body parts can retail for $1,000 US. So these are very pricey animals, Steve.
So why are they so pricey? Are the skills?
So basically...
They make guitar things for this.
So basically these animals, pangolins, are up there like with against the law for poaching like elephants and rhinos.
Yeah, something is going on.
And
it's only people fucking crazy.
It's crazy how that is the main thing where coronavirus came from.
Well, that's what I
But
heard.
This food looks delicious.
No, it's not. Stop it.
Holy fuck. Look at this.
I don't want to eat fucking something that tastes like fucking fingernail.
It has a crunch like a fingernail. It doesn't taste like
and a fingernail. Almost. Uneatable.
Yeah.
So what the fucking point to eat? At least you're hungry. Different stuff.
Yeah. So basically, okay. So a bunch of Chinese people were eating pangolins, and that's basically what happened.
And then, like, start coughing.
Yeah, they start coughing.
And then this fucking shit starts spreading.
So basically, it originated from bats. We're not wrong. Bat shit carries coronavirus. But the problem is bats are shitting on these little anteaters. And then the anteaters are like, well, this is not an ant. This is shit.
That shit tastes delicious.
This shit tastes interesting.
That's fucking look like
I'm getting food falling from the sky for me.
Oh my god.
So, see, we're learning something new every day. I bet you there's going to be a lot of people watching this like, what the fuck is a pangolin?
Pangolins?
And I say, listen, this is what happens when you do
that
research.
That looks like fucking, army fucking end eater.
This is something that the government is not promoting, and they should be promoting, is that if you're a Canadian citizen that is trapped in Asian countries right now, or West African countries, and you're seeing piles of pangolins and buckets on the side of the road, like the guy from Vice said.
But he didn't know that
before. Definitely not eat it.
Yeah, and your body's sucking brain from pangolin skull.
Yeah, and when you see an African sucking the skull of a pangolin, you know there's a problem.
Alright.
And then,
where is the packet? I gotta puke.
So now let's see what the count is for coronavirus around the world right now.
Alright. Hey, what? Google.
No, I'm gonna write it. Fuck your fucking stupid voice for a second. Okay?
My voice is stupid. Fucking Jesus.
Okay, I want fucking... Alright, this thing is already pissing me off.
Here are some results.
Ah, fuck you. Fuck it.
You know how I erase it?
I don't know what I'm doing.
If you want to go to...
I
want to
go back.
But
I want Google.
Yeah.
And then this bullshit pops up. And then...
Close.
I know, but I want to type a new website.
Okay,
I want
so
to
just
go on Google.
Here.
.google. Oh. See, google.ca. That's what I want. And I want to go on the Corona website because they have a live count of who's dying and who's not. So.
Oh, so now we're going to know
Corona.
Who's dying, who's not.
Virus map. That's what we want. Okie dokie artichokie. And let's see, beep, 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 beep. Let's see, we got a U.S. map. Let's see the U.S. map. What is happening with coronavirus in the U.S. right now?
I think it was like 300 something.
Okay, so just in the U.S. alone, we have 3,737 confirmed cases.
Oh, shit, I make mistake, 1-0.
Yeah. The highest is Washington.
This?
Washington State.
Whoa.
Not Washington, D.C. Washington State.
Yeah, I was thinking like all government have sickness.
Bigfoot looks like he caught it over there, okay?
All right.
So basically,
you talk, I go pee.
Yeah, these are the top states with the coronavirus right now. Washington, as we speak right now, has 769 cases. New York has 746 cases. California has 458 cases. Massachusetts has 164. Florida has 155. Colorado 135. Georgia 111. New Jersey 109. And then Louisiana 103. And then after that is all under 100. And so the safest state right now to be in is in North Dakota and Alaska. North Dakota has 1, and Alaska has 1. And then Hawaii has 7. Oh, that's not good, Thea. Okay. And, and yeah, so, yeah, this is, I don't know what website, The Guardian. Guardian has a list. The Guardian website. So, this is basically what the list looks like. That shows all the fucking places where it has the coronavirus in the States. And then where Tia is, Hawaii is one of the lowest places with coronavirus.
They have coronavirus?
Well, it's hilarious because all the guys were telling me Hawaii is a hotbed for coronavirus.
No, it's not. They look like it's nobody care about this,
and
she said.
Literally, Hawaii has 7 cases only.
Tourists?
Montana has 7.
Okay.
Idaho has 5, Missouri has 5, Wyoming 3, and then Alaska and North Dakota only have 1. So those are the safest states basically right now. Vermont has 8. So Victor was wrong with that yesterday. Victor said there was 4 cases in Vermont.
But maybe today is already 4.
He said last night 4 cases.
Yeah, but today is different.
Yeah, today's 8.
Yesterday in Canada was 300 and this morning was 345 or 75 already.
Yeah.
Everybody who come back from other places, look. Oh, Pearson people in Toronto, they find out they have a virus. Like the people who work there.
Yeah.
Customs and everybody fucking get viruses.
Mm-hmm.
And yesterday people come back and the people from TV asking, did you, they advise you, you have to go quarantine. Nobody say nothing, we're going home.
Yeah.
Fucking, like they don't do nothing in our airport yet.
Yeah, so basically Mike Pence is supposed to be the one overlooking everything.
And today, Justin Trudeau, 1 p.m., gonna say new shit again.
Yeah?
Yeah, so we have to wait to 1 p.m.
Wow.
It's gonna be new shit. Because he say every day he adds some shit, what close, what not close, how he gonna pay people, how you gonna have to, you know, they shutting down. Like Italy, I hear...
Mm-hmm.
They suspended all bills and everything. You don't have to pay shit.
Mm-hmm.
Just,
so far,
just buy food, yeah?
So far, because of this coronavirus, I don't have to pay my gym bill, which is $20.
They shut down gym.
Woo! I saved $20. And
they didn't send me nothing. How come you got it and I didn't get it?
And then, well, it looks like you just never pay your gym bill, fucking.
I always pay for it.
And then we save money on internet, so we get unlimited internet now.
No, we have normal price. We don't have to pay overprice.
Yeah, usually we always pay the $100 over usage.
So I don't have to give you money.
Okay,
I'm
Jew.
Safe again.
Jew!
I'm safe again.
I mean, no, that's racist. We can't say Jew. If you call people Jews, that's racist, apparently. Because you know Jews are race.
But you
even
know,
though you can sign up for it.
But you know why the people buy so much toilet paper now?
Why?
Oh, you didn't hear this story?
What's the theory behind toilet paper? Why is everyone buying toilet paper?
You know what?
Toilet paper. Tell me about the toilet paper wars.
Okay, so that's what happened. The one guy sneezed, and everybody's shitting now. And they need that. talking to the people.
I am talking. I just didn't understand that joke. I was just trying
the
to...
The one guy sneeze.
Okay.
And then everybody gets scared and they shit themselves off and now they need toilet paper.
No. But the thing is...
No, that's crazy because people piling shit, you know, for later because you don't understand. They get scared. They don't know what the fuck is going on. Yesterday, Donald Trump said on a thing, he have a meeting with the guy from Walmart, the owner.
Yeah.
And they tracking how much people buying. And he said, yesterday, just yesterday, the people buy more shit and they're buying on Christmas.
Yeah.
So he said, take it easy. You don't have to buy so much shit. That's going to be over soon and just buy what you need. It's open.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but they start chopping hours.
Yes.
Every stores, soon there's not going to be fucking store open, and then when you going to buy it?
Exactly, that's what I'm saying.
That's people thinking, oh fuck, I better buy. We should buy today, you should go with me, we buy like potatoes, a lot of potatoes.
I think people are just really wasting their money on stupid shit over,
and they said,
over something they can't control. No
yeah.
matter how much food you buy, no matter how much fucking toilet paper you buy, no matter how much... hand sanitizer you buy,
yeah.
It is a floating respiratory virus that you could just fucking wake up in the morning and have. And no toilet paper is going to save you. No bullshit fucking chocolate bars are going to save you. Nothing's going to save you. It's just you're going to wake up and it's either you have it or you don't. It's that simple. So there's no point of stocking on gas or anything. Food, there's no point. No matter what, there's wind outside, it's going to blow the virus all over the fucking place, and it's either people are just going to get immune to it, or just a lot of people are going to die, and that's what's going to happen. Thanks to the pangolins! It's that simple.
And bats.
And these fucking idiots are fighting for toilet paper!
And they protect these bats and everything. I will be burned the shit down. Sorry, I have to choose between bats and humanity. You have to give the bats off.
No, the craziest is how people are eating
no,
those fucked up anteaters.
Yeah, but how they know it...
And then people's solution is to buy toilet paper for their assholes. Where does that make sense? That shows how stupid people are in society.
Yeah, but you need some stuff what you need. You need.
It's like people never heard of a bidet.
What is that?
It's a fucking water gun that you put in your toilet that cleans your asshole out so you don't use toilet paper.
Yeah, that's one girl say, you know, you can wash your asshole. You have water. And
you use your hand. Even.
No, but you can, you know, grab some piece of cloth, wash your asshole.
That's what I'm saying.
In the bathtub. And then put just drying out, and then you wipe again with cleaner stuff, and and then you wash shit in the washing machine. But then you're gonna run on the fucking washing shit because you're gonna wash so often. Ah, and the leg gonna go down because you lose so much water. You lose so much water.
Yeah, like you could grab a fucking towel, wipe your ass with a towel.
Yeah, but you have to wash it, otherwise you're gonna stink house.
Yeah, and then when you run out of towels, you start using socks. You know, and then you wipe your ass with a sock.
No, I'm not you.
Like, people have no brains. It's amazing. Like, this shows how stupid our governments are. This is the idiots we elected. Trudeau and Trump. Look at how they're controlling the virus. It went from, like, 2 weeks ago in the United States, it was like, what, 2 cases, and then one guy died in Washington?
Yeah.
Today is now like 3,800 cases, 2 weeks later.
Yeah, because they didn't believe it. Oh, we
and Donald
them.
Trump's like, oh, listen, I don't want to deal with it. It's Mike Pence's job now. The guy...
That virus is the best looking
virus.
Of
all
the
viruses.
Best systems. This is the best beautiful system. Don't worry about it. Everything is controlled.
And then
Mike Pence.
And then,
nothing is under control.
And then,
fucking we're going to be fucked.
And then buttfuck Trudeau, who travels, like, all over the fucking place.
That's not him. His wife went to Britain.
And collects, like, fucking millions of dollars from these Middle Eastern fucks, sending him paychecks every month. And who catches the coronavirus? The wife who does the dirty work for him.
No,
sending her to different countries
collecting
checks. No,
she was in England.
Yeah, collecting checks. That's the only country where Middle Eastern people send their kids to private school. is it number one spot.
Where?
In the United Kingdom.
Oh. Well, I don't know what you're talking about, but it's, I don't know.
Yeah, Trudeau was the one that got in shit for, remember? He was going vacation houses for that AGA guy.
No,
big
I don't know
oil
nothing.
King.
Nothing.
And he was in part of that La Surveillance case where he gave permission for the fucking U.S. to bomb the shit out of some city in the Middle East, and then he went in and started building the Middle East again.
No idea.
And he got guilty for that. Almost went to jail.
No idea.
And then Trudeau goes, honey, I can't go to these places because then they think I'm fucking crazy. So you're going to go for me. And then look, and then she gets sick.
No, I think so she gets some speech in the school in Britain. And then she get it.
No, she does the bullshit dirty work. And then she puts it in her bank account, millions and millions of dollars. So that when they kick him out as prime minister, they're going to be fucking 100 millionaires. And then they're going to retire in a mountain somewhere. They're not stupid.
I don't know. Where do you get this information?
No, I'm just making shit up in my head.
I know. That's what
and,
I'm saying.
And a lot of people think like that right now. Especially with this virus happening. There's a lot of people making a lot of money right now. A lot of money. A lot of money.
So what you said, your friend is in the United States and he said if he want to have a coronavirus test to check when you're sick or something. Or you know what we should buy? We should buy a fucking thermometer. We have no thermometer in the house. And we need it if Tia come back.
What, I'm going to stick it in my ass and check my temperature?
We have to check her every 2 hours that she don't have temperature.
Yeah, oh, she's going to love that when she comes home with you. Fuck it, she's going to grab a sledgehammer from the wall and just whack you in the head.
Just think how she's going to go back to work. She can't go in 14 days, they said.
I bet you her work is probably shut down anyways.
No, they have to take care of people.
They don't care. Are you kidding me?
Oh, who going to feed them and give them medicine?
This is the government solution. No one take care of no one. Sit at home, stare at the wall, social distance.
Yeah.
That's their solution.
I know. But that's what they try to do.
Fucking
because they say
idiots.
They don't want this spike.
It's already spiked.
Yeah, but they want to curve this by 14 days. That's what they say. Everybody have to stay at home 14 days. Because if everybody come back at the same time, no waiting 14 days, go to hospital, we have no more rooms. We're going to spray everything because we're waiting to the... you know, like a line up to hospital. Now they said the smart. Who did this? South Korea. South Korea is very smart. They say they rent fucking like sky domes. So they know people going to the emergency room for coronavirus go to sky dome where they prepare like build a hospital temporary over there.
Okay.
So you know, blocking normal hospitals with. You know, coronavirus.
Yeah.
Just with this. And everybody give tests. And it's gonna be soon. First United States drive-through testing. They basically swipe you and hit the gun.
Yeah.
First they hit the gun. If you have no temperatures, they're not gonna do nothing.
Yeah.
But if you have temperatures, they swipe you. And it's gonna be blocking like check for alcohol. Cops gonna pull over everybody and just checking. So if you're sick, you automatically go to hospital. You have to leave the car, you're going. But if you're not, you go back wherever you want to go. So they're going to do it right now. In States, they do it in Walmart.
Mm-hmm.
You have some tents so you can just drive. You don't have to out. Just open the window of the car. You stick your head. They blip. No. Blip. No. Go. Next one. But if they find sick guy, run away. Goodbye to the van.
Yeah.
So yeah. So big package, stimulant packet, they somehow gonna pay little, they say the restaurants, they have to pay bars and restaurants at least 60% what they're making or they fucking everybody gonna bankrupt.
No, the problem is the fucked up thing that I'm seeing with the government is that everyone pays so much for taxes already, right? So now he wants to just throw that tax money like basically out the window to everyone.
No, you have to do something.
Like, why are you going to give people money when you're closing all the stores down and then no one can spend the money?
Yeah, but
what's the point?
But they still open.
There's no... It's, like, so fucking ass backwards to do that. It's unfucking believable how they're thinking right
Maybe
now.
Maybe they're going to deliver it to
fucking retarded.
Your houses for...
They're retarded. They shut down literally half of the stores everywhere And then they're going to say, here's money, go to the store where all the food is that's closed. And then how are you going to eat? You're going to fucking start shooting chickens outside and kill
or
eat those.
Or pentanol, yes.
You're going to start hunting deers, you know, filled with the deer ticks.
Where they have Lyme disease.
With Lyme disease.
And then you're going to flip
And
over.
Then you're going to eat those deers, you know what I mean? It's fucked up. Trudeau has no idea what he's doing right now. No one knows. The best idea is to let people fill the hospitals up, let them study it, and then figure out a solution from there. The game is patience. If people have the patience, it's going to be solved. If people don't have the patience, that's when World War III starts. Because then
people don't have patience.
Look, there's already people going to fucking murder each other for toilet paper in Australia.
I don't mean Australia.
That's
everywhere.
How stupid fucking you idiots are. All you idiots, fucking. It's unbelievable. Fucking retards everywhere. Sorry for my politically incorrect language. I mean Down syndrome people. Yeah, it's like, and it's crazy. And yeah, my friend from the States says that if you're a U.S. citizen right now, and you want to get tested for the coronavirus, it costs you $3,000 to get tested.
Let's check it out true.
Okay, hey. Ask how much money it costs to get tested for coronavirus in the United States.
Hey, Google. How much money costs coronavirus test in United States of America?
Here's the top search result.
$7.
You got on a Google search $7,000?
$7.
$70 million? Listen, I have a friend who's in the States right now, living there. Just got his green card. He's saying that he went to the doctor, and the doctor is charging $3,000.
Because he's not an American citizen, maybe.
For corona fucking testing. So, basically, like, Google how many people don't have health care in the States.
No, that's the for
no,
free.
No, listen, let's see how much money they're going to make.
Hey, Google.
No, give me the iPad.
I'll write again?
It. Yeah, all right.
Okay.
I'll type.
I go pee again.
Okay. How many people don't have health care in the States? It's listening to me. Stop listening, fucking bitch. Give me a keyboard. Yeah, so basically my friend lives in Vermont, and he's saying in Vermont that you have to pay $3,000 to get corona tested, which is crazy. So, how many people don't have health care in the USA? Let me see what happens. So it says here about 44 million people, okay? 44 million people in this country have no health care insurance.
So it's like 10%.
So let me do the math now. Can you say, hey, Google?
Hey, Google.
What's 44 million times 3,000?
Check out this info.
So basically, they're making $132 billion. That's how much doctors are going to make off of this virus in the next 2 weeks.
Don't they have money now for
people
groceries?
Are becoming billionaires from this virus. Look at that. 44 million people in the United States don't have health care. It costs $3,000 to get tested. That means they're making...
Why does it cost so much money?
And they're gonna make $132 billion.
No, ask Google that the people in the United States have to pay for coronavirus test. Okay, like this. Hey Google.
Do people have to pay to get tested for coronavirus in the US?
Here's what I found on the web.
Okay.
Okay, what I got is no answers, basically.
It's for free, I know. I think so, he's crazy.
I don't think he's crazy, I think he's right.
No, he overacting.
No, he's not overreacting. I'm getting information from someone who's there where it's happening.
Which state he is?
He's in Vermont, which is where they have eight cases right now.
Oh, very nice case.
But it's crazy how much money, like, you know what I mean? And guess what? You have to pay taxes on top of that. And look, half of that money, that billions of dollars, is going to go straight into the government.
Yeah.
For nothing.
I don't think so. They're going to suspend everything. All bills, all tax. Oh, they did in the state 0% in a bank. They dropped the rate to 0%.
It doesn't matter. They still make money.
No, but like they drop it so people, and they're suspending, like Italy suspending all bills for 1 month. So you don't have to pay for nothing.
Doesn't matter. You go to the store to buy bread, you're paying taxes. They're still making money.
Yeah, I know.
No one's saving money.
The best is Walmart today. I'm going for bread.
Yeah.
And they say $3 for $6. And it's big paper. Do not buy any more than two.
So the sale is three loaves of bread for $6.
Yeah, and big paper hanging. Do not buy more than two.
Yeah, because then you end up spending more money for less.
But they don't want you to buy so much, so you leave for people.
Yeah, but...
But it's so stupid why you have a sell shit for three breads for $6 and you can only buy two.
It's, Yeah, I know, that's fucked up.
No, I know, they should have it at least this... Take care of the cell and say, fucking maximum two. Because last time they was empty. Bread was empty. Woo.
Yeah.
So, I bought it one loaf again. A little one for toast. Just in case.
Yeah. And I don't know, these governments are fucked right now. They're like, they're making billions of dollars off of sick people. Like, you know what I mean?
You can't make money on a fucking, like, this situation. That's terrible.
They are.
And the people fucking...
That's 44 million people, no healthcare. They have to pay $3,000 each to get tested.
How are they gonna pay?
Exactly. That's what happened.
But these people have no virus because they can't afford to go nowhere.
That's why there's an outbreak. And that is why there's an outbreak. Because you have 44 million people walking around who can't pay to go get checked. And probably half of them have it.
No, I think so. That's just people who travel that way.
Like, you know what I mean? That's fucking wild.
I know.
That's wild.
I know. And I hear the story, crazy story about churches. Right now in Poland, what I know, it's maximum 50 people just to church.
Okay.
But this government try shut down because it doesn't make sense. Fucking 50 people is too lot, yeah?
Yeah.
So they want to shut down complete churches. And the fucking stupid churchman, whatever, some bishop say, nobody stop people to going to the church even in the second war. That's not second war. That's diseases now. You don't want to spread. Nobody. We have to celebrate Jesus fucking every day.
But are they not praying?
Yeah, but
the corona.
But he say nobody gonna stop, let the people go in if they wanna come in, and that's what he's like fucking poison now people brains, you know, maybe make like a riot because government will complete shut down churches. Don't go to the, whatever we have control find this shit.
Yeah.
But this stupid fucking priest, no, they want the fucking people in. Say still.
Yeah, because if you're gonna die, you're gonna die. It's that simple.
No, I'm thinking the priest fucking is so fucking brainwashed. Fucking if you want to do your fucking shit, you put camera, you do your shit, and people watch you on fucking...
TV at home?
Think. You don't have to have people in. Say. No, but this all data fucking retards. Were you thinking, you know, yeah, where is the God now? Yeah, what? People dying and nobody helping. Where is God? Look at this, Italy. The biggest fucking
church
shit. And the most people died there. Oh, look at this. What's going on?
France. You see what's happening in France?
No, France, the same shit. Yeah.
France right now is getting fucked. You know why? Because they...
And Spain, they said. Yeah.
Why in France is because, you know, the guy on Joe Rogan saying the biggest people catching it are smokers?
Yes, they smoke lots.
And they fucking smoke like motherfuckers in France.
Because he said how you have like some kind of hair in your lungs, or they stop shit everything.
Mm-hmm.
But if you people smoke, this hair doesn't work.
Yeah.
And it's like charcoal. and they know catching what they're supposed to catching. Mm-hmm. Because it's like say like the virus go and gonna catch by this hair.
Yeah.
Eventually he gonna die inside on this hair, but because they know catching is go to your bloodstream, and they say what is I watched yesterday what is the difference between bacteria and a virus virus yeah.
Okay.
And they say bacteria. Attacking system or infecting, okay. And a bacteria growing from bacteria.
What?
They like multiply bacteria from bacteria.
Why? Just ask Google.
No, no, I know this. Bacteria from bacteria, but virus is different. Virus attacking our cells. He attacking cells. He stick to the cell.
Okay.
One cell. And inside the cell, start multiply in the cell. And the cell became like balloon. So much viruses in this one cell explode. Yes. And then they sticking to different cells. Mm-hmm. So that's different. No infection, but cells attack. So that's what they said. If you attack your lungs, too many viruses can kill your red cells. And you have no red cells against the white cells and you're dying.
Yeah.
That's what is problem. But if you catching, he said, you just, they find out on a German guy, mm-hmm. 2 days ago, they said, he get infected and they finally find out that we have actually in our body, antibody who killing coronavirus. And it was 500 some kind of bodies would depress this and kill this virus. So they grab from this guy thing and they now try figure out, you know, how make influenza from this body. But most important thing, this antibodies we have, mm-hmm. but we don't know how our brain relieve this shit when. But this German guy get it, this antibodies,
okay.
And he get healthy and they grab him. Grab his blood and they find out they have antibody who are attacking already coronavirus in our system. So if you have strong immune system, you should be fine. Mm-hmm. But this guy was what, 30 years old or something? So that's what they say, like younger body have better system.
Yeah.
Say, okay, release this guy's over there. Mm-hmm. But maybe old system have like, let's say you get virus, mm-hmm. you get attack yourself. And you have not enough in old body, not enough this guys who supposed to suppress this shit. Like your system maybe send just 3, which is not enough. And then you die. Mm. So we know, I know right now, they said in Germany, they find out we have the antibody who close coronavirus. And she said we're going to do influenza right now, which is going to be very quickly. Mm-hmm. And then she said, fucking how quickly, I almost faint. 18 months. Mm-hmm. Because she said we have to start doing the tests. Because you know what the guy said about Lyme disease? They have a vaccine before for Lyme disease. Okay. That my guy said, remember Joe Rogan. And he said what happened is, they didn't test very good. And they give to people vaccine. And the people who take vaccine get Lyme disease. So they discontinue. Some people just have vaccine and from vaccine they grab Lyme disease.
Yeah.
And they say, fuck. So they cancel this program. Mm. They help somebody, but fuck up another people.
Yeah.
So they still don't know what the fuck is going on with this Lyme disease. So anyway, so we know now, fucking, you know, cover your shit, no sneeze, social distance, you have to believe this shit and don't breathe and everything, like, you know, we gonna tell you story because we have our family member coming from Hawaii next week and we have to do the protocol. We have to do 14 days. We gonna see what's going on and we gonna have first fucking you know, we were surprised they you know they she left before this bullshit start. Mm-hmm. And now she's coming back home and we're gonna deal with this stuff. So far she's saying in Hawaii, beautiful day, 28 degrees, nobody fucking even talk about this shit.
Yeah. Also.
Yeah.
Also,
yeah.
Japan is not canceling the Olympics. Summer Olympics is still gonna happen.
When they said that?
They said that yesterday. The Prime Minister of Japan, whatever his name is, I have it written down.
Yeah, so what?
In my room. He said the Summer Olympics is still gonna happen in Tokyo.
But without people?
No, he didn't say that.
I think so, it's gonna be without people. Also, just sports guys, yeah.
Also, still WrestleMania is gonna happen.
That's, we don't
know.
In
the football stadium in Tampa, Florida.
They don't let them go. I tell you right now, you wanna bet money?
That they're gonna cancel it?
Yeah, of course.
I bet you they won't.
They're not gonna cancel it, they're gonna postpone it, let's say to fucking further, November or something.
People need to make money.
No.
Okay.
See, that's the problem with you. No. This is so serious, nobody make money. Or we never gonna make money if it is spread so much. It's gonna be shit.
What do you mean? I just showed you that $132 billion they're making in the United States alone.
Yes, but I
just
tell
off
you,
of the virus.
But if the people start dying, who gonna fucking work? Nobody gonna go nowhere. Say, fuck this shit. I'm not gonna pay bill. Come catch my fucking house. I'm not gonna know it.
And that's why World War III starts.
Yeah, exactly. They're gonna start shooting fucking cops who come into your house, everything.
Yeah.
And say, fuck it.
People are...
Say, I die. Fuck it. Or I die virus or you shoot me.
Yeah.
So they're gonna be some protests and say, you can't do this to the people in the situation. Like they can't... Like, in Canada, you can't off the electricity if a guy don't pay bill in the wintertime.
Yeah.
Because it's inhuman.
Yeah, it's inhumane. Yeah.
Yeah, so fucking the same thing. You can't kick the guy out if it's fucking some plague. And if you no pay bill, credit gonna go down, fuck.
Yeah.
Because you have to leave.
And if you're gonna trap people in other countries and keep them there for a long time, then they're gonna be like illegal aliens.
Yeah, you know why the people...
And how are you gonna deport them?
But they said, you don't have to come back, run away.
Yeah.
Because people now fucking just jumping and coming back. You have a little bit of time.
Yeah.
You don't have to go tomorrow. So these people in Canada yesterday panicked and they was on Skype saying, man, I tried book the flight. Fucking everything is booked to the fucking next week.
Yeah.
And I said, yeah, because everybody on one fucking flight. You can't fly from nowhere on one fucking all people coming back.
And that's what happens. They wanted people. They wanted the. This is why Canada government is so stupid.
Yeah.
They want less people to fly. So their solution is to fly home right away. You know how many Canadians are fucking all over the place?
I know.
Now you're going to have fucking like 2 million people show up at
like
the airport.
Like they showed at Chicago. 4 hours just lying.
Yeah, waiting.
On the customs. Like sardines.
Yeah.
Fucking coughing and everything. And they said, that's ridiculous. So the woman said for CNBC to the U.S. doctor... He said, so what, we should spray them? No. You can't spray so many people like fucking and keep them on the plane, say, fucking 8 hours before they're coming out.
Yeah.
You have to let it out. Go quick. Have this, do. Okay, this sick, go here. This, okay, go home. This, that's quick. You know, keep moving. Don't make fucking everybody breathing everything and this bullshit stuff. And yesterday, this one guy said this was fight in the line too. One kid say, "Oh, one guy knocked somebody by accident," and the guy have mask and say, "Whoa, you sick fucker!" And you try spray on me, and they start fighting inside. Fucking, he said, "It's craziness."
I know. And their solution is to get, hey, we want social distance. We want fucking millions of people to fucking sit on planes with each other now and fly back.
No, social distance is at home. That's what they smart doing.
But that's what they're saying to these people. Go home, back to Canada.
Yeah,
and
everywhere.
Now you have millions of people fucking now together in rooms.
Because they don't say enough information.
Like
people, look, people
like
panic.
Fucking idiots.
Okay, everybody come back home. Not, you don't have to come back like run away. But let's say in between 2 weeks.
Yeah.
So start doing. No, run away. They don't say the timelines. People don't know what the fuck will happen tomorrow. So everybody jump, run away and say, we are about to fucking get the fuck out of here. Because they're going to close the... And what? How are I going to get
but
home?
But it's stupid. There's corona there. There's corona.
German?
There's corona at home. There's
no, but they, in Germany, now they close the borders. Only Germans can come back.
Yeah.
Somewhere else too, they were saying this morning on the news. So everybody closing borders. Now just your people can come back. That's it. All people who work there have to have a permit
coming. But right now it's like everything is unbelievable. So
fucking chaos everywhere.
So anyway, we healthy.
Yeah, right.
I'm 51.
Yeah, and I'm young, so we're okay.
So dog is fine. We're just waiting for my daughter, which is our family member.
Yeah.
And we let you know what's going on.
And make sure you don't eat pangolins, because they're filled with corona.
Yeah. So that's how cookies crumble.
And that's it.
And that's peace and good luck to everybody.
Goodbye.